First one created for God is revealed to us. Who is God revealed in today's readings? The first reading reveals a God who hears the prayer of the humble. The prayer of the humble is heard by God. There is one story of Psalm talks about the humble taking refuge in God, because God is the refuge of those who are lonely. The second reading talks about God giving strength to the humble ones, as Saint Paul to us, in spite of all the persecutions that he had experienced. And finally, the Gospel talks about our God, who exalts, who lifts up, who praises those who are humble. God loves the humble, exalts them, and embraces them. And you know why? Because God Himself is humble. God Himself is humble, that naturally the humble ones are attracted to Him. And naturally God embraces them because He Himself is humble. Now, the greatest act of humility of God is the incarnation of Jesus Christ. It is God who decided to be humble. How? By becoming man. God becoming man, meaning experiencing our dirt, experiencing our sweat, experiencing our odor, our smell, experiencing the mud on our feet, experiencing being hungry and thirsty and having difficulties. Jesus is the proof of the humility of God. And there He falls. On the dirt, carrying a cross when He is God. He humbled Himself. That is God, our God, who is humble. The second part of our reflection today is that is God revealed to us today in the readings. The second part is our faith exposed. How do we respond to the humility of God? How do we respond to the humility of God? We can only respond to the humility of God by our own humility. Who amongst you are humble?
No one.
Who amongst us will play humility? Can you raise your hands? Come on. Oh, no, there are no Christians in this church. We pray for humility. And what are the acts of humility that we need to learn how to do constantly and strongly? The first reading teaches us humility in prayer. Praying is an act of humility, because in praying we recognize that there is someone greater than us, that we cannot claim that I am the greatest of all. You walk around with your head up high, feeling, believing, knowing, claiming, and proving that I am the greatest of you all. Greater
brings us
to where we should be. Down in our hearts, lower than anyone else, lower before the presence of God. Sponsorial song teaches us humility in charity. When we become generous, when we listen to others, when we listen to the cry of the poor, when we listen to one another, when we help one another, we are getting out of ourselves because we believe that we cannot do it on our own, and others couldn't do it on their own. And so we remove ourselves from ourselves and feel the emptiness of others with ourselves. And you call that charity. And you cannot be charitable unless you are humble. When we are dependent on God, that is humility. Because we recognize that our life is not our own, that the world is not ours, that we cannot live on our breath alone. And we recognize that God is His worth. And we become dependent. That is humility. Dependence on God is humility. And finally, the gospel teaches us that humility, by the tax collector, is acknowledging that we are sinful.
Yes.
We cannot be walking around thinking every night that we come across the person, oh, that person is very sinful. You talk to somebody and in your mind you say, oh, again, this sinful person before me. You cannot watch the news and say, oh, those government leaders, they're just evil, without seeing who you are. The beginning of holiness is the acceptance of our sinfulness. Because in the acceptance of our sinfulness is our belief for conversion. Is our belief to be holy. Is our belief to come back to God, who must humble himself so that we may know what you mean in this.
Correct.
Release it. Release all the pride. And attach ourselves to the only ability of God. Only that way. Only that way will we open our hearts and our minds to God and to others, so that our spirits may be filled, so that our spiritual background may be filled. Unless we are humble, we cannot live in the spirit of God. Humility.
Goodbye, humility. Goodbye, God. Look at me.